Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to Gamestah's coverage of the ESEA Australian's Counter-Strike Global Offensive Open Ladder. My name is Gamestah Niebuhr, and I am here once again to bring you a battle on the ESEA ladder, of course, is what I've just said, and I'm bringing you a matchup, the second last game of regular seasons between FireUP and SYF Gaming. This is a very big, important match, as you can see there. FireUP just on the cusp of 8th position, and SYF currently well cemented themselves in the top 8, and a lot to be played for here tonight in the game that we're about to bring you, ladies and gentlemen. FireUP, if they lose here, could be putting themselves outside of a finals berth, and with a lot of reputation and prizes to be playing for, the boys will be wanting to give as good a showing as they possibly can be doing in tonight's match. We're going to be going to Mirage, and this match, of course, was played on Monday night, and they're getting ready for the knife round right now. So let's actually get across. Let's bring up the game screen, shall we? Here we go, and into the game we go, and let's bring up the teams for you. For Scythe, we've got Gunlock, Squishy, Nerox, Inno, and Dexter. For FireUP, we've got Ulala, Opaque, Vok, Padlin. I was about to call him Paladin, but Padlin and Gratis Faction. I was about to call them Gratis Faction hyphen, like in something in there, but and of course a Vox in there as well. So guys, thank you very much for all of your feedback on the post, which I've been putting up as we get into round number one. SYF Gaming will be going on CTs first, and FireUP will be going to the T side. Thank you very much for all of your support and your comments. We'll be trying to put them into play in the upcoming cast that we do. We'll be trying to get a few boys in, try to get the names right, and we'll try to do a lot more stuff. Have a little bit of fun, have a bit of a chat. You know, we'll just keep things light. Nice and casual here. We're on Mirage, of course. One of my favorite maps, just for how up close and personal it is. Love seeing this map. It just does a lot for me. Anyway, so we're going to be starting off here, and the T's are going to be pushing up through apartments and directly onto site. Dexter with the big double to start us off. And he played very, very well in the middle of that smoke. Padlin and Gratisfaction. I want to call them gratification for some reason. That's not right. I know it's not right, but we'll try and get myself out of that habit. Vok will grab another. There's the double to end it up and FireUP getting off to a good start. So as we said, guys, there's a lot to be playing for tonight. With only one more game after this one of regular season play, basically these are two teams trying to cement themselves and get themselves a top spot. Basically, the top of the leaderboard with Direwolves and Frenetic Array are basically, they're locked in. But the boys behind them, there's literally, I think there's about five or six, probably actually the top 20 are all kind of separated by only about two rounds. So every win from this point onwards is kind of necessary, and that's a great way for SYF to get started. Inno and Gunlock will both grab a first kill. Vok will respond at top mid. Some good AK work there, dropping him down the response frag. 2-for-1 trade there. Good work by SYF, but FireUP will need to work a bit here. And yeah, as we said, guys, it's all pressure, and these boys, obviously, it is the best of ones, so, you know, they do have to prepare their strategies. Get all of their spy work, I guess you could call it, their information. Does anyone spy in Counter-Strike? Probably. It probably happens, you know. We all watch stuff, we all try to talk to one another, but you know what I mean. Anyway, the boys will be trying to get off to a good start here. We do see the early scout buy from Squishy. He's going to be putting up that to some work over towards the mid-area, just making sure that he can keep that range distance going on, especially on Mirage. There are the long lines in the A site through mid, even through apps if you can get on top of Van and stuff. But realistically, this is a map that favors the mid to short range weapons. I find the AKs, the M4s do really well on this map, and something that they have to be worked out for. Anyway, the bomb has rotated through the ups, and now they're pushing A, and Squishy will get the first, the jump shot with the scout. Well done. Opaque finally drops him down, and it is now a 3v1. Opaque is the last man alive. He's trying to put that bomb down, but will not be able to get it because Nerox from CT spawn stairs will drop him down there. Good pistol work. Anyway, that's going to give SYF Gaming their first round on the board. And as always, guys, this is a replay, and I do like to, if you have any replays from the ESEA ladder that you would like me to shoutcast, I am always up to do it. I also do try to keep, I always try to blank out the scores, which I've thankfully been able to do with this one as well. So I actually not casting with prior knowledge. I don't like doing that because it just, I think it becomes too... too predictable, and maybe you can tell how it's going to go if you don't know just by my voice. But I always try to keep out of it just for a lot more fun. I like to witness it as the game unfolds, much like you do. Let's turn X-ray on there. That's actually good. There we can actually see what's going on. Oh, there's the incendiary. Great work. Vok is now forced back, and he will have to be very careful here. And there's the smoke. Dexter pop flashes around. Oh, he's very well done. We'll grab one. Nerox actually grabbed one as well. So they've opened up this round, making it a 2-for-nothing exchange. Padlin, Opaque, and Ulala will have to finish off the rest of this round. We got one onto the A bomb side. That was Ulala, but he is now taken down by Inno. So now the... Let's have a look. They are collapsing. There's the bomb over in the A site, trying to come up through the tunnels. They'll have to be very careful here. Padlin looking for anything. Will not be able to get it because Squishy will drop down too with some rifle. Using the rifle. The poor man's rifle, I like to call it. It's not as cheap as an SMG, but not as expensive as the M4. Probably just as deadly in the right hands, I have to say. The Famous is... For the cost to kill ratio, the cost to damage ratio is probably probably one of the best out there, I have to say. It just does a crap ton of damage. The terrorists, however, they're going to be pushing over towards this A-bomb site once again. They are pistol rounding it here, so they're going to have to be very careful. But out they push, and here they go looking for the kills. Won't be able to get the opening frags because Squishy grabbed 1-2. Ulala finally gets it, but it's been 4-for-1. Make that 5-for-1 as he gets dropped down. Gunlock will grab the kill, and SYF Gaming have lost the first, but they've gone 3 back-to-back rounds, and they've brought themselves into the driver's seat of this one. Now, I like to say Mirage is only slightly CT favored, only just because... of the angle work, and I mean that in very, very, you know, it can be worked both ways, but here, if you can set up your lines correctly, you can really shut down a lot of these pushes, and that's what I mean. Gunlock, he bunny hopped his way up into Palace, as we saw there just 15 seconds ago, grabs the opening pick. They weren't expecting him to push up that far, and because of that, here they go, and like I'll show you at the beginning of the next round, there tends to be a defensive line set across here, essentially, sometimes. That will be your standard hold, I've found, just from watching the pros play. And to me, everyone else is really a pro, because I'm nowhere near as good as these guys, and Vok and Inno will go 1-for-1 trade. Inno now will be the one who will be playing the rest of this round. Anyway, I've been having a look at the graphs as well, guys. If you actually want me to try and start using, you know, this screen a little bit more, try and get you some information, let me know what you'd like. I'm trying to be, I think, total damage dealt and maybe even money spent. There are a couple of good ones which we'll have a look at using in the future. Anyway, here comes the T-push, looking to go through apps. They spot up one. They get the tag. That was Dexter, and he's forced to hightail it out of there. We'll jump now down behind wall. Spots up one. That's a Gratis Faction, and he will drop it down. You just make these tongue twisters for us. I tell you what, Padlin will grab one. That's a Padlin, and Dexter will drop him down. Padlin with the double, and looking for the triple. Oh, he's got three. Could go four here. This would be a great clutch. Won't be able to get it because Squishy waiting on the angle, and will drop him down. 5 rounds in. SYF Gaming, 4 rounds to 1 up. Fire it up. Fire up. We'll have to fire up. And probably get themselves back into it. Probably not the start they would have liked. Let's have a quick look at the scoreboard. 5 rounds in. Squishy leading the way on 8 kills, 0 assists. Dexter and Inno, 5 and 4 respectively. Gunlock and Nerox bringing up the rear on 3. Vok and Padlin, 4 kills apiece, but Vok with 3 assists. So he's getting a lot of kill participation in this opening half. Gratis Faction, Ulala and Opaque. I've seen those names a lot, but they haven't really done a lot. Anyway, the pistol moving in through apps. Have to be very careful here. We're currently following Dexter. He's got that HE nade. He spots him out. He lets go with the HE, puts it right in their face, and there goes the incendiary. Nirox then grabs 1, 2, 3. Thanks to the help of that incendiary. That is great play. There's one more up there. They know he's up there, and Dexter will go from van into apartments. He will grab the last one. Gratis Faction is on top of mid, and that's going to be the perfect round. Will it be? No, it won't be because Gunlock was dropped down. But they only lost one person in that eco round for FireUP. They unfortunately lost every single one of them. But they will buy up now. 5-1 on the Gamestah scoreboard. Of course, guys, hit that like and subscribe button if you're around. And let me know if there's anything you'd like to hear me say, shout-outs you'd like me to give, things I'm calling wrong, all that stuff. You know you want to, you know what you want to critique, and I'm happy to listen to your constructive criticism, guys. That's what we're here for. Anyway, it's interesting to see how some of these boys now. None of these guys actually participated in ACL Sydney, but they are right on the cusps of being part of that top eight that could have played. So these guys looking to really try and make a name for themselves. Gratis Faction will take down Dexter. That's really good. He runs over the incendiary looking for the double. Can he get it? He gets the second chance shot and will make it count. But that is a really good play. Opaque was waiting in Palace, and that is going to be a bomb planted. And Scythe, I actually don't know they think that this is A yet. They haven't actually rotated. They still could think this is at B because the terrorists are just waiting on that site. Who is that? That is Gratis Faction. He's going to be waiting, and he's going to be pushing now. He will be dropped down finally. And that bomb is, however, ticking all the way away. Squishy and Inno are the last two remaining. Squishy, they're not going to be pushing this. They want to save the M4s. I'm fairly certain they know where it is. Squishy is now sitting on CT spawn. And he is not going to be going anywhere. He's going to be looking for a couple of exit frags. Will he be able to get it? No, he won't. Inno will grab one. He picks up the AWP for his trouble, though, so he'll be very happy with that. But FireUP will get their second round on the board, so that's what they needed. A very good play from FireUP, actually, to force that B rotate, and then they just couldn't actually go. I think it was actually very late. They still may have actually thought it was at that B site. They just couldn't do anything about it. Anyway, full buy-ups from both teams. I'll show you this defensive line if I can see it. There's the Palace across jungle, and normally you'll sit one at window in this short area and here. So as you can see, they actually are kind of nearly lining up. That's kind of that defensive line that I talk about, guys. You'll probably maybe see it a little bit more. I will have a look at their tactics. We'll try and get a little bit analytical towards the halftime. Squishy comes out from under balcony. We'll spot up one. That was Opaque. Actually, got him through the wood there, so good M4 work from him. 1 minute and 5 seconds remaining on the round timer. Round number eight ticking away from them. Gunlock, he's got that AWP. Oh, he won't miss, though. Gratis Faction will be strafing out, and he will take no further part in this round. Once again, Dexter, he will be looking up and towards this app area. There is no one around that area. However, he's going to have to remove here. Vok, currently sitting on short. He's trying to get anyone at window, but they don't know where they are. The rest of the T's are just trying to back into this apps area, maybe make a push on B. They've only dropped no one. They've only dropped a bit of health, actually. Gunlock has been dropped down about three-quarters of his health, and Squishy also being dropped down by about a quarter. Ooh, Vok, he almost gets picked off, but Nirox, he was looking in apartments, didn't expect the short push, and here they come. Pushing in, there is one on top of apps, and Dexter, he grabbed one. Vok with a double, looking for the triple, won't make it work, because Gunlock, he's got that AWP working inside of kitchen. Padlin will grab one, he jumps up onto apartments, but he gets spotted out by Inno over at short, and he will drop him down, giving SYF Gaming their sixth round for the half. Well done, 6-2 in favor of SYF Gaming. We'll do a score update in a couple of rounds. I always see Inno's name, and I always remember, like, it's the handball from primary school. You know, when you're playing handball, it's like, oh, Inno's, mate, get out of here. I've got to stay again. The things that your names remind me of, guys, probably either one makes me sound like a dork, or two probably shows my age if some of our younger viewers don't have no clue what I'm talking about. But once again, we have the pistol round for FireUP. This is probably the third eco in 9 rounds that they've been forced onto thanks to the dominating performance from SYF Gaming here. Nirox will grab the first kill. Padlin will be dropped down. Inno from underside of stairs will grab the other. And they are just, it is a annihilation, I guess you can call a systematic destruction of FireUP at the moment. They have lost four members and only this man remaining. It is Vok. He is the last man to try and do anything. Will he be able to do anything? Let's see if we can find him and find out. Well, I've actually been talking to no one is what I've actually realized I've done. I've pressed the save button. That this guy, there he is, he's Vok, trying to control the camera, guys. He's got the dig. Can he get the one dig? No, he cannot, because, you know, with the flash from Squishy actually helps him out and drops him down. SYF Gaming goes 7-2, and they are only one round away from being at the half, the leaders at halftime, is what I'm supposed to say. That's what I was trying to say. And that's a very comfortable position to put yourself on as a CT side, especially on Mirage, when realistically the momentum of either side can very quickly swing the rounds ticking over in a favor. If the Terrorists get the momentum flowing early, man, they can be hard to stop, and especially on this match where the time that it takes you to get essentially into the sites from your seat from the T-spawn, if you're going A most of the time, you can be in the site in less than 10 seconds. And if the CTs aren't wary of this, that can, like, I've seen repeated pushes there. I've seen repeated apartment pushes through short. Really, you can open up a bomb site very, very quickly. The boys from FireUP, though, I think they want to be working this A site once again. Here they go, pushing up into the A site. There goes the incendiary grenade. Ooh la la from On Palace will spot up one and continue to push in. They've got actually the first one kill, and they've got that bomb down. There's the second kill. Gratis Faction from inside of Connector will drop them down. Oh, Vok. Very well done. He's trying to get his pre-fire on. Dexter will get the rotate. Oh, ooh la la, with a great shot. He only had a minute to think about. Spots one up, and that was Nerox. He was on very low health. They didn't need to get the bomb down, but basically, he is the last man alive on a lonely, lonely server, essentially. Nine people dead, and only Ulala remaining gets the AK for his trouble, and third round for FireUP. 10 rounds in, quick score check. 3 SYF Gaming boys are on 10 rounds, 10-4, 10-2, 10-1 for Inno, Squishy, and Dexter, respectively. Nerox on 9, bringing up there. Opaque has to pick up for FireUP. He's currently only got one kill. And Vok, Gratis Faction, Padlin, and Ulala, 8-6, 5-4, respectively. A little bit of a kill spread around there. And they're doing pretty well. But, you know, they probably can do a lot more. And they can pick it up. I think FireUP, they need to lift here. I've used the FireUP, need to FireUP pun already. And they will need to push. They are going to try and fake out an A rotate. There are 3 at that bomb site. And they're going to try and try and fake it out. That bomb, however, is going through apartments, so they will be looking to open up this bomb site. They don't actually know, though, that the CTs are stacked, and once again, that bomb's going to back out of this one. They've still got 45 seconds, so that are they going for a fake? They're going for a double fake. Is it a triple fake with a bluff? Let's find out. They're now going to be pushing mid, trying to open up Connector in mid. I think maybe push this A site, try to get a pick, and see where they can go. Vok will get his Connector spammage. There's the flash. Opaque, he turns around right at the right time. Oh, can he get the spammage through the wall? No, he cannot, but they come in now. 1-for-1 change. Make that 2-for-2. All the boys. Squishy with a big W. A big double, I should say. Gratis Faction and Vok, though, will both find one apiece and make it an hour 3v1. That's very good entry frag. They went from a 2-for-2 exchange for a 4-for-2, and that is exactly what they needed here. Need to get a couple rings strung together, and currently Dexter needs to pull something out of his ass right now. A 3v1 clutch can be done, but he's got 2 AKs and an AWP to beat. I don't think he's going to go for it. He's just going to look for those exit frags. He's sitting under window. Yes, he will. He's going to have to look for these exit frags. Gratis Faction comes out. Oh, that's the AWP drop. And the Molly to boot. He's going to be very happy with that. Picks up the Molotov grenade and the AWP for his struggle. Will go into underpass. Will not be disturbed down there. Much like a troll living under the bridge. He just sits down there and waits it out. 7-4. FireUP now coming back into this one. SYF Gaming actually have seemed to be, I say, hit a bit of a rut. It's only been 2 rounds, guys. I mean, but the question is, will FireUP be able to get any more rounds in a row? That's the question they need to figure out. If they can actually get that kind of Oh, if they can get off to a great start, Gratis Faction, he will not be happy about that one. He gets dropped down. Dexter, he did see him, but he did get blinded as he strafed out, and that was very good work. We do seem to have a disconnect here from SYF Gaming, so expect to see probably a pause after this one. Opaque and Ulala both connect up, make it a 2-for-1 exchange. They are now going to be pushing into this A-bomb site, and that bomb, though, is coming from mid, so they have to be very careful, but they find the last one. That is Nerox, and FireUP will win this round very, very convincingly. We should see probably the match pause. Yes, there it is, whilst we wait for Inno to get back on the server. He's back in, and I think we have a match started. Yeah, we're straight back into it, so thankfully he wasn't gone for very much longer. But if you have a look here, have a look at all of these round eliminations that you can see. It's basically telling the story that, as I said, Mirage is that up type of up-close and personal thing that map that either two things will happen. Either A, you have these bloodbath of exchanges, which is what we've been seeing, or B, you see a lot of either explosions or, like, retakes. Oh, Gratis Faction, great shot. Takes down the bunny rabbit. That is Dexter. There's the double in Nerox. Through the, actually got him through the wall, so very, very well done. Gratis Faction, he'll be finally feeling very good about himself. I guess you could say he's feeling Gratis Faction. Yeah! Anyway, that's the worst pun that I've probably done tonight, but in he comes. Opaque will put that bomb down, get the start, that timer. And Gunlock, ooh, he gets binked quite a bit by Ulala. Ulala strays out, looking for the spray, can't get it. And it's going to be Squishy, Gunlock, and Inno. And I don't think they're going to push this one. No, they won't. They are going to be sitting back once again. They rather the M4s and the AK. They've got a couple of rounds buffer, but if they lose this one, we are back to one round. FireUP. And that's what I love about this game, guys. It was 7-2, and just like that, we are about to have a 7-5. That just shows you how fast momentum can swing. Like I said, if FireUP can get... It's kind of like a tug-of-war match, I like to put it, is that, you know, if you've got all of the momentum, if you let up for 1 second and the other team put the pressure on, you can lose your footing, to use the tug-of-war metaphor, you can lose your momentum, and it's very hard to start that back up again. It's only one round. We've got 2 rounds remaining in the half, and there's quite a lot of kills going on. 12, 10, 11, and 10. Look at that. They're nearly all in double digits for SYF Gaming. FireUP, though, on we actually have Opaque. He's been the resident bomb carrier, and slash, he's got 16 points, and he's got 2 kills and 0 assists. He's actually beating 5-1 and 5-1 Ulala and Paladin. Padlin. Not Paladin, Padlin. That's a Padlin, neighbor. Oh, you betcha that's a Padlin. Anyway, bad Simpson references. Let's move back on to the Counter-Strike GO match that is ahead of us with 1:13 remaining. FireUP are certainly in control of this one. They've got the opening frag, and that is causing... It's going to be causing a lot of issues here for SYF Gaming. FireUP, they put the Molotov down under a balcony, making sure that no one's going to be sitting there when they drop out. They have to be careful, though. There's the double nade, just making sure that, again, no one's sitting in those the little cheeky cutaway spots. Opaque now jumps over Tetris. We'll get spotted out, though. That's a 1-for-1 exchange. Make that 2-for-2 as Vok joins the party, taking down Nerox. And here they go, once again, pushing in. They clear out jungle. They have to be careful of CT stairs here. They don't know that Squishy's backed up on the CT spawn. But there's a great shot from Ulala, looking for the double long range. AK shot, gets the headshot eventually. And that is 7-7. Fired up. Fire up. Have fired up, and they are now firing on all cylinders. They have lined, brought this one back to a 7-7 scoreline with 1 round to go. They could be in front here at halftime. SYF Gaming, having been up 7-2, honestly will be feeling that they need this round because realistically, they should have had this half, you would think, or at least that's what I think their mindset would have been. They honestly felt like it was coasting. I don't want to say they were coasting, but maybe just took their foot off the pedal just a little bit. And they are paying the price for that now. 2v2 exchange. Gratis Faction grabs Gunlock and is now an AK. Two AKs and an AWP versus an AWP, a Famous, and an M4. Let's see what happens here. There goes the pre-nade. They will actually bink Inno right on CT stairs. They know he's over there, but they just cannot find him. He's just a little too sneaky. Ooh, Gratis Faction. He's going to be coming in now. They will give him the coordinates. And will he be able to get that headshot? Squishy, though. Oh, well done from inside of the jungle. We'll spot up Opaque. You know, though, strafing out with the M4. Grabs one. That's a great 2-for-0 exchange. And now there's one man remaining. It is Gratis Faction. And that bomb has been dropped down. That will be a bomb down call. There is one sitting in connector. There's also two sitting on CT stairs. Has to be very careful here. Nerox, he's going to be... They should be peeking him together. He won't actually do anything. This the silent game. He spots out one. There, he's been giving his position away, but Squishy waiting on CT stairs. He didn't know the second was there. And SYF Gaming, whoo, they'll be happy to get away with that one. They actually take the half... They take the lead at halftime, 8-7. They'll be very happy with that one. Let's settle down, guys. Let's have a quick recap of what we just saw there as these boys, as I take a quick drink of water, and we'll have a quick recap. All right, so, that's nice. Right, so, FireUP win the first. SYF win about the next, they win six. They win seven of the next eight. They go 7-2. SYF, FireUP, come back, winning 5 of the next 5, and SYF finally close out the half, 8-7. So, as we said, that once these teams get that momentum flowing, it seems to be that they will keep a hold of it. Now, FireUP, they were looking very strong towards the end of that second half. Now, SYF Gaming, having won that last round, you could say they've put kind of the brakes on that momentum train, the comeback special, as it were. But FireUP now on the CT side have to control the pace, the tempo of this half, really. They have to hold the line, and that's very aggressive work from Gratis Faction. Comes up through mid, up to top. There's a really good Molotov. They spot out this apartment thrust. Padlin grabs one. Inno and Squishy will make the exchange 2-for-1, making it a 3-for-3 now. There goes the bomb plant. 35 seconds remaining in this round, one way or another, at max. But SYF Gaming are not out of the hot water yet. Opaque will grab one. You know, looking for the return frag. Gets it. That was Gratis Faction. There's the double. It's now a 1v1. You know, looking for the 3-down. He doesn't know where he is. He spots him up, though. Who's going to get better of it? Ulala's going to push him. And the USP 2G gets him straight through the head. He's got the kit as well. That will be the defuse. And FireUP will get round number one of the second half, making it 8v8 once again. But that bomb being put down by SYF Gaming is a good sign of things to come for their terrorist half. They can get to the site now. Obviously, let's see how they go here. They're going to go... Nope, they're not going to go... SMGs, granted they didn't win the round, so, you know, that kind of makes sense. But they could have force fired SMGs here if they wanted, but they are deciding to just go with the pistols. We see only a flash and the P250 by Inu. So, Inu? Inno. He's not an Inuit person. He's an Inno. He's an interference in the game of handball, guys. That's what he is. Anyway, and they are going to be pushing now this A-bomb site. 4 of them currently sitting in apartments. Ooh, that's a very interesting defensive line we have right across here. Gratis Faction, he's going to be just making sure that no one's pushing through mid into short. 1 minute and 8 seconds remaining on the clock, however. So, here they come, though. This is going to be a timed nade push. They have one flash, one shot, one opportunity. Inno is going to be the guy who has to launch it. So, there goes the counter flash. They think they know where they are, but they actually don't know. But here comes the push. The nade is out. There's the flash. But Opaque and Gratis Faction both will let rip. And there is the clean. Wow, they didn't even get one. And that was... All right, I'm going to give SYF an A for planning, a B for execution. They had the flash, but however, for them, FireUP were just two on top of the ball. They were waiting and ready. They thought that they were going to come in. Obviously, FireUP have had their Wheaties this morning, and they are going to be pushing in, and they're going to be playing a little bit aggressive here on this A site, playing up pretty far. Ooh la la, just outside of balcony. Have they got the spot? The Gratis Faction spots up one. He knows there's one in the smoke, but he doesn't know if there's any more. Ooh, ooh la la, right next to Dexter in connector. No, that's not connector, sorry. That looked like connector. It was actually the A archway. And we'll grab one. Ooh, that's a sexy Hyper Beast. I love me some Hyper Beast action on the M4. And SYF Gaming, though, need to lift now. They need to lift soon. They need to really stop losing the first man, the first pick. That's really causing them a lot of issues in these rounds. They've, especially on attack, if you go into a site one man down, I mean, sure, you try to split the defense and try to find the site that has the least amount of players, because then obviously that gives you, you know, a 5v2, 5v3 advantage. But every pick you allow them to get, and it sounds very obvious when you say it, but every pick, every man down is a man power less that you get when you go into a bomb site. Now, the question, where are they going to go? Are they going to go up? Yes, they're going to push this A bomb site. It looks like they're going to be pushing through window. And they'll probably time this push through connector. Here they go into this A site. They clear out. Make sure window room's clear. Opaque will grab one. Nerox will get the return frag. One for one. And they need to get come off better here. They won't, because it's now a two for two. Ooh la la, Nerox. That's good, but not the best. Padlin with the Famous will come through jungle. He knows where they are. Will he be able to get the last frag? He lets rip with the incendiary. Spots up one, and the Famous spray 2G takes down Nerox, picks up the M4 for his troubles, walks on his own incendiary grenade and says, hut, 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 hut. Does the dance like you would on top of the coals. Mind over matter, he says. Fire up. 10 rounds to 8, and they move. They're in front. They have hit the front, and they hit the front last round. But they are extending their lead, which is what I say. Now, have a look at this. The opening three rounds, two defuses. That's nearly more defuses than we had in the entire first half alone. So that's basically telling you that SYF, as they go to their pistol round here in round three for the half, they are getting to these sites, which is, like I said, is showing so is good. They just cannot convert these into rounds. Gratis Faction grabs the first kill. That was an underpass. Ooh la la, though, is going big for himself. We'll grab one, two. Inu will grab the return frag. Dexter, he's just playing back here. That is a bomb dropped in connector, so they will have to be very careful about that. He does push, tries to get this, get a pick. Can't get it because he gets dropped down. 11 rounds to 8. Fire Up are only 5 rounds away from GG's and a possible top 8 spot. This is very, very big. Like we said, guys, with only one more game to play, every win, especially for these two teams, is vital. If they can get a win, it basically can put, you know, they hope for some losses from the other big wigs. You know, this is like, if SYF lose to Fire Up here, that's a very big backstep that they may not want to be taking. So if they can actually get this win, they actually put themselves probably a game clear of some of their nearest competitors. And like I said, from about 5th to about 20th, they are separated by about 2 games. One win is all it will take. A lot of round percentages need to actually, will actually come into it. So let's see how they go. 1 minute and 5 seconds remaining on the clock. They're looking for the picks. Can they grab them here? 1 minute remaining. There goes the bomb. Well done by SYF Gaming to actually own this site now. They've got the opening frag. That's really good. Fire up will go 1 for 1. Make that a 2 for 2 exchange. Padlin will grab double before finally being taken down. Nerox and Gunlock will make it a 3v1. There's only one man remaining. It is Vok. And that is a very good defensive Molotov grenade. That means he will have to scurry on out of there. Has to be careful because there will be one looking through. And he gets dropped down. That was Gunlock. Great work with the AWP. And SYF Gaming needed that one soon. And there it comes. That bomb will not go boom anytime now. 11 rounds to 9. SYF Gaming, they're trying to basically defend essentially 4th position on the ladder. You know, they are up there and they are probably finals contenders, and Fire Up looking to prove that they are also top 8 material, and they can duke it out with the best boys. Fire Up, however, are now on this pistol eco. We have three Deagles, a CZ-75, and what I think is a 5.7, I'm fairly certain. So this should be round number 10 to SYF now, but any kill they can get will be really, really good for Fire Up. They need to get as many kills as they possibly can, dent the economy of SYF Gaming, make sure it makes it as easy as possible as time. But SYF Gaming are not pushing anytime soon. They are holding this top mid and this apartments area. They are not crossing this center line yet. They don't know that FireUP is on the pistol round. If they did, they would have pushed in by now, I guarantee it. But unfortunately for them, they're going to sit this one back. Now, it's not unfortunate. They're just going to play this one slow. They want to get the pick. They want to be sure of it. And they want to get another round in the bag. Dexter will grab Opaque. He played a little too aggressively for his liking. And now, once again, SYF Gaming are going to be pushing in up towards his apartments into B-bomb site. And with 30 seconds remaining on the clock, they're going to have to get right onto this site and put it down as fast as they possibly can. Squishy playing in center now. He's getting binked straight through the boxes. But Squishy and Inno will grab one. Squishy with the double. But that bomb has now been dropped down. And it is now a 5-1. Vok, the last man remaining. And SYF Gaming will basically go very, very clinically and drop down FireUP. Well done. So 11 rounds to 10. Once again, FireUP are put under the pump here by SYF Gaming. And we have a match pause. These boys are just going to take a second. Have a breather. Let's have a quick score check, shall we? After 21 rounds of Counter-Strike, Ulala leading FireUP with Padlin just behind him, 15 and 12, respectively. Gratis Faction, 16 and 4. So he's been doing a lot of work with that AWP, resident AWP of FireUP. On the other side, SYF Gaming, Nerox with 14 and 0. Squishy with 21 and 3. And still doesn't have the most amount of points on the board. How does that one work out? Anyway, well, I suppose that's the half. That's what I should say. That's actually the half score, the 11. That's actually not his full score, so that kind of makes a bit of sense. But he's leading the way with 21 and 3, and, you know, is right behind him with 17 and 4. So a lot of work being done on the SYF side. They're all in double digits, except Opaque. He's probably lagging behind. He's probably got to go into his solo games, maybe versus some bots, maybe work on them headshots. I know that's certainly what I've got to do. And maybe he just wasn't warmed up. Maybe he didn't have his Wheaties. Maybe he needs some Wheat-Bix. Get some Brett Lee about you, mate. Need to how many do you do? 10 seconds. Match is now on pause. Now I can stop filling the time with bad advertising TV commercials. Anyway, SYF Gaming looking to tie this one up once again. If they can bring it back to 11 rounds to 11, they certainly will be looking pretty good in the rest of this match. They will obviously want to bring it back as much in their favor. They once again as well have that defensive line. As we said, Opaque, as I was showing you, that drops into Palace. He didn't drop, he jumped into Palace and dropped down one. That was Gunlock. Gunlock's actually been, he's been a bit unlucky in a couple of these rounds, I actually have to say. He's been dropped down very early in quite a few rounds. And the boys from SYF Gaming trying to make it three rounds in a row, trying to put themselves in a great place. But Padlin has something to say about it. Gets the 5-7 to work. Grabs three kills from inside of ladder room. And he basically has stopped this push single-handedly. Squishy spots one, looking for any more. He doesn't know that one's behind him now, and he's going to be taken down. That was Vok. He just played ring around the rosy. Squishy was on the wrong end of that that one. And FireUP now make it 12 rounds to 10. Four rounds remaining for them if they can get it to 16 rounds to 10. But we could be going all the way to 30 here. The way that this game is kind of going out is that it is going back and forth. However, in saying that, it is going back and forth after long periods of time. See that four rounds. We have two before it came back to FireUP. But in the first half, we had five rounds. Basically, each side, essentially, either half, I guess you could call it the quarters. You know, the first eight rounds and the second seven, I guess, they're the quarters. SYF was in front, probably in the first quarter. FireUP basically came out and said, you know, we'll control the map from here, thank you. SYF were very lucky to get ahead at that halftime point. But with a minute and 10 seconds remaining, they are now going to be pushing out onto this A bomb site. They're going 2-for-2 exchange. And Dexter is now waiting out in mid, trying to get the pick. He will find Padlin as he came through ladder room and makes it a 3v2. Gratification. Gratis Faction. Why do I do that? I just get words in my head and just think, yeah, that's what it's going to be. Vok from jungle finds Dexter. He drops one down. Here comes the... ooh, that's a very good incendiary from Gratis Faction. He will grab down one. He won't grab down any, but he forced one out of the spot. And that will allow Vok to now be the to get one from jungle. And Inno, he has the bomb, but he can't go and plant it down because he knows as soon as he does, They're going to be popping out here. Makes the call. But there's the one from Connector. Vok jumped out of window. And he will drop him down. And who is that? That is Gratis Faction. Will come in for the defuse. 13 rounds to 10. Fire up looking well in control of this match at the moment. SYF Gaming, though, can't be counted out of this one. Will they go for an eco? Or are they going to force buy here? They do have Dexter on pretty low HP and pretty low money. They're going to have to... They're force buying. They're going for it. And they've got... Dexter's going to go full armor, but... Oh, he's forced by the AK as well. So he's going to... This is a very, very important round for SYF Gaming. If they lose this round, they essentially put themselves on an eco next round, which will make it 15 rounds to 10 if they go that route. If they lose this one, it's not over yet. But Gratis Faction says, I'm going to get the opening frag. You know, it will drop down at the top of mid. And that is exactly not the start they will want in this one. Nerox trying to put the spam down on window. And that's just a very nice flash from Gratis Faction. Just drops it in the middle of window. And with 1 minute and seven rounds. 1 minute and seven rounds? 1 minute and 4 seconds now remaining. It's a very good incendiary grenade. Nerox now trying to get the spam. Can't actually get the kill. Gratis Faction. Oh, he misses the shot. It was practically a gimme. And Squishy made him pay. Nerox got the assist there, but he also grabs one of his own. That was Ulala with 45 seconds remaining. SYF have made the exchange 2-for-1. And they haven't committed to a site yet, but that bomb moving around the back through T-spawn up towards that A-bomb site. So you would think that SYF Gaming now on the A-site will want to be pushing there. But there is one on the site they haven't accounted for. I think that's Vok sitting on site. Yes, he is. No, it is Opaque. He's sitting up on top of balcony. They don't know where he is. Can he get one? Yes, he does. Looking for the double. Won't be able to get it because Dexter came through and will drop him down. Vok, though, with that Hyper Beast, looking to put it to work. Oh, he's got the bomb planter through the box. Very, very smart, but he knows he's in a rough position. He has to be careful. There's one. Oh, my God. Fire up Vok with the three down. The clutch. He's made it 14 rounds to 10. He knew he was in trouble, and that M4 spam had to be good. It was great. It was better than great. It's given his side 14 rounds to 10. And from this point onwards, SYF Gaming must win every single round from this point onwards to come back into this one. Can be done, but it is putting them... They are on such... They, like I said, they look at that. They've got a P250, a Tech-9, two Galils, and an AK. Man, they put a lot of money into that last round. And here they come. There's the flash. Vok will grab one. Gunlock will get the one-for-one exchange. And out onto the site they come. They've put the speed on. And they've actually caught Fire Up a bit unawares here. Padlin will be dropped down. And it is now a two-for-one exchange. SYF Gaming with the pickups. And that bomb planted. So that's actually a very, very good eco round start from them. Dexter will grab the next kill and make it now two remaining. Oh, Nerox and Dexter both go big and Fire Up. Wow, you would think that maybe they'd come big after that, but they've practically just gifted SYF Gaming an AWP, an M4, AK, and another M4 off the back of an eco round. Wow, that is very, very good work, SYF Gaming. We'll have to feel good about that, but they are riding the knife's edge, however. They still, like I said, look at their economy. If they need to win at least this next round to put themselves in any kind of good position. If they don't, again, they could be looking at the back of a partial force buy. And that and this later stage of the game, every gun is crucial. Fire Up now, as you can see, however. They are also ecoing now. They're taking a step back because they realize that if they lose this round on an eco, which is fine, they still have a two-round buffer, but they want the money to invest into the next two rounds after that. That's pretty much what they're doing here. They need their... But they could eco twice and ensure they have the money for the next three rounds. It'll be interesting to see what they do here, but how will they hold? They've got the pistols. Maybe it'll be a reverse of what just happened. Ooh la la, he won't be able to get the first kill because Gunlock basically dropped in on his head and will drop him down. But that bomb, now on the A-bomb site, they did stack this B-side and they guessed wrong. And Vok though, ooh, good start. Ooh, could be taken down. No, he won't, but oh yes, he will. Thought he would be taken down by the nade. Oh, Opaque puts in two big kills when they need it. He's going to be looking for three. can't get it, but Gratis Faction. We'll grab one. Squishy versus Gratis Faction. Squishy. We'll grab the big kill. 14 rounds to 12. SYF Gaming. Well done by them. They could come back, like I said. But four people were dropped out. They have the money. Ooh, a Zeus from Dexter. I don't know if he meant that one. I don't know. But here we look, FireUP. We've got two Famuses and three and four. So they're going to be playing the mid game, the mid-range game, I should say. And they're going to be looking to try and close this one up. You would hope. Oh, is that a bit of a... That's a... a bit of a misnade there, unfortunately. 1 minute, 20 seconds. You know? Just a bit of spammage from top mid. The boys, just taking a step back. No need to rush. Still got possibly four rounds of Counter-Strike to play, guys, including this round. I mean, we could be going all the way to 30. Well, la la, we'll get to a good start, though. He finds Gunlock. The Terrorist boys now working this mid area. They like to control the mid, SYF Gaming. And push out wherever they can get the picks. We're having lost Gunlock, however, that will bring down their offensive power quite a bit. Although, like I said, Gunlock has actually been getting dropped down very quickly in the rounds. Probably something to think about come next team meeting. Maybe is there a way to possibly extend his lifespan? Nerox grabs one. Gratis Faction grabs another. It's a 2-for-2 exchange, making it a 3-for-2 now. Ooh la la, Bok and Padlin. They need to hold here. This would be a great round. Nerox gets the molly out. That's a great defensive. Ah, but ooh la la, somehow survives. Oh, he's just in the corner. Oh, is he surviving that one? There's only one man remaining. It is Squishy, and he is no longer down because, like his namesake, gets squishied. Finds his flesh is squishy and very good at soaking up bullets and FireUP. They are looking at possibly causing what you would consider an upset given their ladder standings, I have to say. FireUP, they could be looking at cementing themselves in the top six with one round to play. They basically, they still will be riding the knife's edge, but they basically will put themselves up into the top eight with this win if they can get it. There go the nades. SYF Gaming, though, they know that this is probably not going to be a lot longer if they can't do anything. Padlin and Vok. Vok with the triple. They've all come out. It's now down to Nerox, and they're going to be... They tried to repeat what they did in their last eco. Try and take the boys from SYF, from FireUP. Try and take them unawares. Unfortunately, it didn't happen in this particular one. FireUP are now going to actually move to 11-4. SYF Gaming going to go to 12-4. And wow, that tells you quite a story right there. SYF Gaming they should stay within the top eight. Maybe they'll drop down one position, probably to fifth. And FireUP, I think they'll probably jump up here. We'll have to wait until the other matches are all kind of done and dusted. But ladies and gentlemen, whoo, well done to FireUP. Wow, they got through this one 16 rounds to 12 over SYF Gaming. FireUP will be absolutely happy with that effort. They should be. If they're not, well, you know, they can only improve from here. They've still got five, possibly seven positions to make up. So, look, guys, hopefully see both of these two teams in finals if that's the type of match we're going to get come the best of threes. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of tonight's coverage of the ESEA Australian Counter-Strike Global Offensive Open Ladder. If you enjoyed what you've been listening to, my name is, of course, Gamestah Neighbor. Hit me up on Twitter, at Gamestah Neighbor. Please like and subscribe this video. You know you want to. There's more of this stuff coming. We've got Let's Plays. We've got League of Legends stuff. We've got more of the finals of ESEA, the Australian Ladder, coming up. I'll be covering that one as much as I possibly can. So all of your support is greatly appreciated. Anyway, once you've done all that, guys, have a look around. If there's any other games, hit me up on Twitter. Let me know if there's anything else you'd like me to cover. All that stuff. And it does help me out in the long run, guys. So, hope to see you around. Anyway, on behalf of me and all the guys from Gamestah, thank you very much for your company this evening. Please go out into the world, get those frags. Good night and good game.
Gamer, do you know what it takes to be the best? Even if we do.
Elite Shoutcasting Network.
Are you listening?
What up, ladies and gentlemen? It's Neba. This is Nebra is a Noob, and of course I am the noob that we are talking about. We're going to play some more Let's Play, we're going to play some Counter-Strike Go again.